Mural, a painting or other work of art executed directly on a wall. Murals, they indeed have a message behind their art. Sometimes strong, sometimes soft, sometimes a cry for a change in this world today. In Miami, Florida, an art community called Wynwood blossomed in 2009. The community is painted with murals from different artists to express their social message, including women empowerment, preserving wildlife, and the concept of birth, death, and social struggles. What is the power of murals? Why specifically in Wynwood? Do these murals have a meaning?
My name is Claudia la Bianca and I'm originally from Italy.
So my name is Reinier Gamboa. I'm a local artist here in Miami.
So my name is Ivan Roque and I got into the murals circa 2010.
So I believe, I call myself a Wynwood pioneer because I moved to Wynwood back in 2002 when there was not even the promise of Wynwood. I happened to be a roommate of this architect in this huge warehouse, and you know, there was nothing out. There was only like crackheads and bad news, and these huge warehouses, these huge empty warehouses where eventually artists move into to turn them into their studio. So I kind of see everything developing, you know, how Wynwood from really nothing, not even the promise of Wynwood, became what it is today, which is beautiful, it's progress. And artists have helped create this, you know, this international known district of street art. I started painting murals in Wynwood out of love, really. You know, I just started, I was here for a long time. I knew all the buildings, so I had an urge to, I saw in murals a powerful way to communicate. And you know, most of all, my purpose in life is to inspire. And I saw just a very fertile ground into the murals. What was the murals could do for me, for my art and my message. I knew I could impact a lot of people. And also I was doing something I love, which is paint. So I kind of planted seeds, which were my murals, all around town. And then eventually, Wynwood just bloomed, and I guess I bloomed with Wynwood.
Well, Wynwood is, I would say it's the epicenter of the local, at least, artistic community. At least like internationally, there's a strong pull towards like educating people about what street art is about. You see all kinds of styles there. It has the most density in terms of public art of anywhere in Miami. So I think it's a really good spot to be noticed, not only locally but internationally.
Like I was in downtown, and then I just started seeing all the walls and all the murals, and then I saw in art box a lot of people start painting, and then I would go there on Sundays mainly, because on Sundays there, like literally when it was completely empty, all the businesses were closed, the cops wouldn't even be driving by, so it was the perfect time to go do illegal activity there and paint and, you know, start doing like, you know, throw ups here and there, and you know, I'd go and drink, smoke with my friends, and then little by little started getting better. And then 2013 is when I did like my first real actual mural.
Well, the power of murals, it's not to be underestimated, because murals are huge billboard that people drive by every day if you have a good wall. So the power of a mural can be, you know, can be a change maker, can make changes, can inspire somebody, can intrigue somebody, can, you know, make somebody curious. So I saw how powerful murals were, you know? That's why I started doing them.
Murals, the beauty of murals is that anybody can see them. You know, it's trying to reach the public. That's the whole idea of it. Whereas like most of the work that I and my other studio mates do, it's meant to be seen in a private setting, in a gallery, someone's home. So that really limits the amount of eyes that can be on a piece, you know. Besides social media, which is another way of putting it out there, doing public works is just the best way of at least locally reaching an audience. So to me, that's the number one advantage, is to engage in a dialogue with whatever community you're choosing to work in.
So murals have the ability to be able to change society. It's the only art piece in which the most richest person and the loneliest crackhead can basically sit there and look at art and appreciate it for what it is and create their own message. It also has a direct impact on economy and direct impact on as far as the overall feeling of a neighborhood, you know? So in a way, like, you know, we're the ones that control everything. But like I tell people all the time, like the artist most of the time is trying to send some sort of message. You know, take those 30 seconds and really look at it. You know, go up to it, see the marks that it's made, you know? Some of these artists, if you think about it, like, you know, yeah, sometimes it's, and you can be like, oh, like, you know, I could do that. When the reality is, you really can't, because it took that artist 30 years to get there. It took that artist 40 years to get there. Some artists, it took 70 years to make that one mark on the wall, but all that knowledge accumulated to these marks and to these styles and all that, you know, years of struggle, years of pain, years of just passion that one must put out to get to that point. And the fact that they didn't quit along the way, you know, along this path of both dark and light.
Every artist paints for a specific reason, a message to be interpreted. These murals stand for a powerful being, to be heard and to be seen.
The perfect time to focus on that, you know? I mean, I've always been about woman empowerment. I've always been that kind of little kid that will, you know, make sure I will stand for myself and I will have a voice and I will have, you know, I will go follow my dreams and I will listen to my instinct and I will say like, well, I'm gonna follow that, my heart, because I believed in the power that one, you know, that one have. Like I believed in my power, and so through my work, I believe that I can communicate that, because I went through it. You know, I went through the bullying when I was, you know, young, because I was overweight. So I was getting bullied by all these boys. I wasn't feeling pretty. I wasn't feeling like I was worthy. And through drawing and painting like this superhero woman, I was able to go through it. And while I was, you know, home crying because I was getting bullied at school because I was fat, I was a fat girl, you know, here I am. I was, you know, in my desk drawing this beautiful, strong woman, and they saved me. So why not bring them back, those characters that have saved me? Why not make them something, you know, for others, for other women that they're looking for that, for other women that they're looking for that type of alignment, for other women that are looking for that type of say, yes, you're doing good, you are worthy, you can do it, you can do anything.
So the Anthropocene just means that it's human caused. So humans are causing this, exactly. Yeah, so we're putting a lot of different species under a high level of stress. And we're losing species at a rate that we're not even aware of. So that's part of the reason why that mural is important, because it shows some of the local species that we're all familiar with, but they're also, a lot of them are in danger. But it's a whole mixed bag of different species coming together, which is, I feel like it's relevant because that's just the way things are, you know. It's not just like, oh, here they are over there, here they are. Everything's really mixed up. And the idea of it is that we are, as humans, what we do matters. You know, we have an effect on this planet. And we're supposed to be the guardians as the species that is the most cognizant about what is happening. And so I feel like we're not really owning up to the fact that we are guardians, you know. So part of our growth as a species overall, because I feel like humans as a species, we're very young, you know, we're still very immature, we're almost like as a whole, like children, you know, that we're not even aware of what we're doing. You know, we're so detached from the way things work that we're completely like, we're causing havoc without realizing our part in it, you know. So I feel like it's a pretty noble cause to create some work that brings that to the forefront, that creates some sort of awareness that we are responsible.
So when you look at my works, it tends to have a subject matter, which is usually animals. It'll have vines enveloping the character, whatever the main focus is, and it'll be flowers as well. That being in tune with the symbolism pertaining to whatever I choose as far as the flower or the animal. And then it also shows human nature at its very primal setting, right? It's basically, because all animals are basically running on instincts, and us as humans, we've learned to be able to control those instincts and contain it, so that way they don't either destroy us or they, you know, elevate us. So it all depends on that sense.
Murals.
As you can see, they indeed share a strong, powerful message. They are energetic. Murals build a sense of community. If you want to learn about a city, simply look at its walls. Murals act as a voice of the people, displaying unique art pieces on large scales that create conversation and sometimes even help create social change. Murals are the message. Your love in one day. Just say.